Shame I gotta wear this bulletproof vest. 100 degrees outside. This thing on is 110. You lose about 5 pounds a day just sweating on that. Freeway, the pavement, it's even hotter out there. So you might get up to about 115 degrees.
442
Well, I kept my job as a police officer mainly because of the benefits that I get from my job. I get free medical, I get free dental, I get free life insurance, and all of these things that I just named off. None of that stuff comes from bodybuilding, but another one of the most important things that I also get from keeping my job with the police department is a retirement, and I can retire in 20 years and still have a check coming in from the police department. Whereas in bodybuilding, none of the things I just named you don't get, none of the benefits you don't get from it. So that's pretty much why I kept my job. And plus it allows for a great balance in my life. You know, I'm just not one-sided. I'm not just doing one thing. I'm also keeping myself busy, taking my mind off, you know, so like bodybuilding. You know, you might get tired. You might get stressed out from it. Just thinking about if you're gonna have enough money for this or enough for that. But also, you know, if something happens to me, you know, I don't have to worry about that either. Or if I get hurt, seriously injured in bodybuilding, you know, I don't get a check from disability or from workers' comp. But you know, with my job as a police officer, something happens, I always still have that check coming in. So it takes a lot of stress off you, and it gives you that balance. That's pretty much why I kept my job. And I always keep it. The hardest thing for me maintaining both my jobs is it's a mental thing, and mentally I've always been a strong person, and you know, it's a decision that I made myself. So I'm constantly aware that hey, I'm gonna have to work 10 hours, you know, 4 days a week, putting in full shift at my job. And I'm constantly always reminding myself that I'm going to have to do that. And when I say about the mental thing, that stressful part of my job is also a mental thing. I know it's going to be stressful. I know it's going to be a lot of things going on, like accidents, and I'm having to make arrests, and there's going to be suicides and murders. I know all of this is going to happen. So what I do is I tell myself that hey, I made the decision to keep this job, and I'm going to have to go out there to do whatever it takes to keep it. So it's basically the mental approach that I take to my job is what makes me be able to do both of them, because believe me, it does get very, very difficult, and it is not easy at all doing both. But like I said, if you're mentally strong, which I believe I am, because I wouldn't be able to do both if I wasn't, then you could do both. So I just take the mental approach of, you know, I made the decision to do this. I know the stress involved, and I'm gonna just go out there and do whatever it takes to get the job done.
Time for late night snack.
chicken tenders, about 2 days worth, and that's turkey, about another 2 days worth. So all together, all that food is 2 days worth. That's measured out in 12 ounces. This is gonna be measured out in about 14 ounces. I have to eat on the run, working 10 hours a day. Food has to be pre-prepared. So you cook it all at one time, make it last 2 or 3 days. That way, every time I come home, my food is ready, because I don't have time to cook. It's a 16. Well, one time on the chicken and 3 times on the turkey. Yep, 4 pounds a day. Plus another 8 for breakfast. 8 ounces for breakfast. So it's like 4.5, almost 5. Okay, everybody, this is Brian Thompson. Brian is the guy that got me into bodybuilding about 7-8 years ago. A friend of mine brought me to this gym. Brian was the guy that told me I needed to be bodybuilding. At the time, I just started working for the police department and I didn't want to do it. Brian was insistent upon me bodybuilding, told me that I could do good in the sport. Finally told me that he'd give me a free membership, and I said, oh, what the heck? Not only was he there teaching me how to pose and how to die, but he also gave me a lot of confidence, backing me up 100%, telling me that I could make it in this sport. And as you can see, Brian himself is a top amateur bodybuilder around here in the Metroplex. And as a matter of fact, he's doing a contest today, and then 9 times out of 10, he'll win that show.
What's up, sir?
And Brian has been bodybuilding for about 20 years, so he has all the expertise, and he knows what it takes to be a professional bodybuilder, because I'm one. He wanted to get me where I am today, so he's truly indeed a great inspiration for all the people that comes around here.